subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see what is the most effective 40 days NEET plan in order to score above 650 marks. So, because without spending minimum of 12 to 13 hours per day, it's hardly impossible to score above 650 marks. Okay, so now let's begin the video. So coming to NEET, it completely has three different subjects, which is physics, chemistry and biology. Coming to physics, it is most toughest subject among all the three. Coming to chemistry, it's moderate subject. And coming to biology, it completely has two different, zoology and botany. Zoology is very, very easy, and coming to botany, it is more one of the moderate subject. Okay, let's see how many chapters does each of this subject has, so that we can prepare the study plan based on these three chapters. Okay, coming to physics, there are 28 chapters. Chemistry has 30 chapters. Biology, including zoology and botany, has 38 chapters. Okay, so now let's decide the study plan for last 40 days for NEET. Beginning of the video only, I told you it is important to spend at least 12 hours per day. So coming to this 12 hours, we are dividing this 12 hours into three different parts. Okay, we'll study physics for 4 hours a day and chemistry for 4 hours a day. Spend 4 hours for biology. Okay. Okay, so coming to number of days. Okay, totally we have 40 days left. And on the first day, coming to physics, start preparing from basic maths. Okay, so coming to first day, biology, start preparing from your living world. Okay, this is important, so start preparing with living world. Coming to chemistry, start preparing with mole concepts and oxidation number. Okay, so this is the complete plan for day one. Okay, make sure you at least try to complete 90% of this particular chapters. Okay, so first day is you need to follow all these three chapters. Okay, so friends, coming to day two, this is the day two plan. Okay, coming to day two, coming to physics, concentrate on unit dimensions and error analysis. It is very important coming to physics. Coming to biology, concentrate on cell, the unit of life, part one. Okay, coming to biology. Coming to chemistry, you need to concentrate on balancing of redox and equivalent reactions. So this is the day two plan. Okay, so same here also, at least try to complete more than 90% of this syllabus in your day two. Okay, so guys, coming to day three, under physics, you need to cover the concept of vectors and rectilinear motions. This is important. Okay, so coming to day three, under biology, you need to cover cell, the unit of life, part two. Okay, so coming to chemistry, you need to cover concentrational terms and equivalent concepts. So this is the day three syllabus. Okay, so friends, coming to day four, under physics, you need to cover this particular chapter, which is projectile motion. Coming to biology, you need to cover cell cycle and cell division. And under chemistry, you need to cover qualitative properties. Okay, this is the schedule for day four. Okay, so coming to day five, under physics, you need to cover the topic of motion in graph. And coming to biology, you need to cover principles of inheritance and venation. And coming to chemistry, we need to cover Nomenclature. Okay, so this is the day 5 schedule. So coming to the day 6, you need to cover under physics Newton's law of motion, and coming to biology, molecular basis of inheritance, and coming to chemistry, it is all about structural isomerism. Okay, so these three are most important and you need to cover this under day 6. So coming to day 7, under physics you need to cover work, energy and power, and coming to biology you need to cover biological classification, which is one of the most important topic, and coming to chemistry you need to cover stereoisomerism. Okay, so all this comes under day 7 schedule. Okay, so under day 8, coming to physics you need to cover collisions, coming to biology you need to cover plant kingdom, and under chemistry you need to cover polymers, biomolecules and chemistry in everyday life. So coming to day 9, under physics you need to cover circular motion, coming to biology you need to cover morphology in flowering plants, and coming to chemistry you need to cover periodic table and periodicity 1. Okay, so this schedule comes under day 9. So coming to day 10 schedule, under physics you need to cover center of mass and moments of inertia, coming to biology it's all about anatomy of flowering plant, and coming to chemistry you need to cover periodic table and periodicity 2. Okay, so this schedule comes under day 10. So coming to the day 11, you need to cover rotational dynamics under physics, and under biology cover reproduction in organisms, and under chemistry cover periodic table and periodicity 3. To the day 12, you need to cover gravitation under physics, you need to cover sexual reproduction flowering system under biology, and coming to chemistry you need to cover S block elements and hydrogen. Okay, and this is one of the most important topic under chemistry. So coming to day 13, you need to cover mechanical properties of solids and thermal expansions under physics, coming to biology cover animal kingdom, and coming to chemistry cover solid states and states of matter. Okay, coming to day 14, you need to cover mechanical properties of fluids under physics, and coming to biology please cover structural organization in animals, and coming to chemistry cover thermochemistry 1. Okay, so coming to day 15, you need to cover KTG under physics, coming to biology digestion and absorption, and coming to chemistry you need to cover thermochemistry 2 and thermodynamics. Now let's see what are the efficient and effective tips and tricks in order to crack NEET with 650 plus marks. Okay, so first what you need to do is you need to concentrate more on the weak topics. I'm sure that each of you has one or the other weak topic in every subjects such as physics, chemistry or biology. Okay, what you need to do is concentrate mostly on them so that you can score marks even in your weak topics. Okay, so next important tip is that you need to solve sample and previous year's papers. Okay, why I am telling this one is 60 to 65% of previous questions, like previous year's questions or similar kind of questions, will be repeating every single year. So what you need to do is you need to solve the sample papers as well as previous year's papers in order to easily gain 650 plus marks. Okay, so third tip is give mock tests. Okay, when you give mock tests, what is the advantage is you'll understand how to manage your time during your exam, and you'll also know where you are getting stuck, in which particular subject or in which particular topic you're getting stuck, so that you can practice more often and you can easily get good marks in your final NEET. Okay, So next tips are strictly follow your study plan. Whatever study plan I have given just now, strictly follow that. If you strictly follow that study plan, you can easily score 650 plus marks, okay? And next is maintain brief notes, okay? While studying a topic or while studying any particular chapter, so make sure you maintain a note so that before few minutes of the exam also, it will be easy for you to revise all the important topics, okay? So make sure you maintain a brief notes, okay? So next is start studying early hours. Once you wake up at 3 or 4 in the early morning and start studying whatever you study in this early hours, you can easily remember that topics for so long so that you can easily recollect them in your exam. So it's always good if you start studying in the early hours also, okay? So next, start revision unit wise only, okay? So few students has the habit of revising first part of the chapter and then last part of the chapter, and then they'll suddenly start revising from the middle part of the chapter. No, that's not the case. Always make sure you start revising only unit wise and in a structural format so that it will be easy for you to remember in the exam, okay? So next is take small breaks, okay? If you start studying continuously for hours and hours without taking the small breaks, your mind will not be refreshed and it will be so hard for you to remember things, okay? So it's always important to take small breaks, okay? Have healthy foods and have a good sleep. What does this mean? You should always eat healthy while your studies and while your exams, and you should also have an adequate sleep, okay? And then be confident and stay positive. What does this mean? So if you're confident and if you're positive, you can easily score good marks in your exam. If you're not confident, if you're always nervous, then there's a possibility of forgetting the things which you have already studied also. So it's always better and good to be confident and always good to be positive. So now I'm going to answer whether the NEET exam is postponed or it's not postponed. So most of the students are thinking that it's postponed. No, that's not the case. As of today, there is no official announcement regarding the postponement of the NEET. So the NEET 2020 is going to be conducted on 26th of July itself as scheduled. So yeah, I hope I answered your question and I hope I clarified all your doubts. So yeah, that's it for today. Students, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such notifications. And once you hit the bell icon, you will be notified whenever I make a new NEET video. Also, do like and share this video so that it will motivate me to do more and more NEET related videos for you people. Yeah.